And there's been nothing for it but to fill it with tears. Tears which change the vacancy and muteness of immediate grief into a reflecting pool. In the enormity of the loss, I feel I see just how far Adrienne's presence reaches into my life. And I draw comfort from being near those who were and are near to her. We need each other now. For each of us carries an aspect of Adrienne that, in reflecting her particular impact on us, reassembles and reflects her tremendous impact on the world. Last Pesach, I found myself haunted by a melody in which I had grown up in another century as a Golas Yid, a diaspora Jew, floating in a falchion above a kosher butcher shop across the South Bronx, back to Kasvilivka, where as yet unbeknownst to me, Adrienne was acquiring mastery of the words and music through which our souls could come into their own and fully articulate something otherwise inexpressible, an ecstatic sorrow, a remarkable serenity amid misfortune, a fierce determination shot through with sadness, a wild longing gratified in the expression of a joy ranging from sensuous pleasure to a hushed sense of holiness, an experience raised to a form of knowledge through nuanced play with accent, voice color. I felt these qualities in Adrienne from the moment I met her 30 years ago at Evo. I immediately loved her. I found in her surplus, her reserves of power, her great warmth, a sister I'd lost in the chaos of our common history. The qualities that characterize her gifts as a singer, an artist and culture bearer, are inseparable from the qualities that comprise her gift for intimacy. She sang as she loved. She loved as she sang with all her heart, with all her soul, with all her might. It was good to be with her in the rich and vibrant quietude with which she surrounded herself and me when I visited her in hospital 3 weeks ago. She talked about the suffering she'd endured with an equilibrium that astounded me. She was spiritually intact, indomitable, took pleasure in conceiving of her next project, a CD of songs of gratitude. The tears she gave over to me were not for herself.